Welcome back. With us now is Mr. Amr Abdulrahman, the political analyst. Good morning, Mr. Amr.
Well, good morning to you.
Thank you for coming over to the breakfast show. Let's talk about this very important visit. How do you assess the fruitful steps or the soft power? Let us start, better to start with the soft power, the very popular studied soft power by the Egyptian administration regarding our neighbors in Somalia, our neighbors in Sudan, our neighbors in Iraq, Libya. That soft power have achieved a lot, have achieved things that we haven't achieved in 60 years. If you like to start off with this.
Using soft powers have shut down many conflicts and many ignited conflicts could have been dragged the state into wars, whether the Renaissance Dam file or in the Libyan file. Using exactly the soft power has preserved our powers, our capabilities to the right moment. And I'm sure this moment is coming. Maybe soon, maybe later, but it's coming. We should preserve our most of our powers for this moment. Because we can never run away from conflict when it comes to a point of action. And it's coming. But we are just delaying the final contest and the final...
And do you think this soft power could change the course of what is expected in its worst sense?
We are dealing with evil powers that are trying to drag us into conflicts to the east, to the eastern borders, to the western border, to the western, to the southern borders. All of our borders
and
are opportunist
interests
with fire.
And also opportunist interests in our on our land and our property and our of course, this is understandable, but talking about soft diplomacy and soft power, this has opened gates for Egypt and have shortened miles and miles and miles of efforts.
Exactly. Right now, we have three important files. Speaking of the African file, it divided to me right now into three files: Sudan, Somalia, and Libya.
Sudan, Somalia, and Libya.
Yes.
Why?
Because we all remember the book, Personality of Egypt, Dr. Gamal Hamdan,
okay,
Professor.
Dr. Gamal, the prominent Gamal Dr. Gamal.
He said that, or he mentioned that. We have not only strategic borders, the traditional borders that we have, we also have what he might call it international interest borders, international borders that beyond our own borders, our strategic borders. That security international borders go beyond our strategic. To the south, it goes all the way to the beginning of the Bassin, the Nile Bassin in Ethiopia. To the east, to the Euphrates Nile. And to the west, most of Libya, and even all of Libya, maybe exactly at the red line that Mr. President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi has drawn. Not to be stepped over. Right now, I believe that the threats are being escalated in the past 5 years. We have witnessed initiating that line of fire around Somalia. There is an unrecognized state, only recognized by two countries in the whole world. It's called Somaliland. Somaliland is a part of Somalia. It was taken by the British colonization and divided from it despite the will of its own people, its own leadership. Right, just out of the blue, we found that a state is being initiated, and there is a regional country that has invested a big investment in this unrecognized state, along with the support of the Ethiopian leadership to this divided state, an unrecognized state in Somalia. That Somaliland is a thorn in the side of African best interests and security and stability. And it means that what is threatening Somalia is threatening Egypt. We are not a small country. We are not just, we have never been as a country, we could never defend our borders by only committing our defenses to these borders.
Of course, unity and solidarity with other neighboring countries.
But
then the threat is not from the outside interests also, but from the inside terrorism. I mean, those militant groups, Al-Shabaab and all that, is even more dangerous to Somalia than the outside threats.
We all know that terrorism is masterminded by the US and the Mossad and the CIA and the MI6 and whatsoever.
Has Somalia been able to stand up to those threats, internal domestic threats like Al-Shabaab, because it's quite heavy?
Look, in the past era, we should admit that we have neglected Africa, but with the beginning of the presidency of Mr. President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi, we have regained our own strong relations with Africa. Africa cannot do without Egypt, cannot stand in solidarity without Egypt. We share the same blood, we share the same roots. So the Somalian nation, it's a nation, not tribes, it's a nation. One of the oldest and the most ancient nations in Africa. And we belong to the same roots that we belong to here in the continent. We should, and we are right now, declaring that we are standing with Somalia. Without this, Somalia can never face alone all those threats. We have all recognized now, each and every person, ordinary person in the world, we have come to the knowledge that the Houthis, what they call themselves, Hezbollah, or the non-Muslim terroristic group, they are all masterminded by international intelligent enemy organizations. So we are facing the same thing in Somalia. And by the standing and the supporting of Egypt, Somalia can face those threats. And we should press on this and tackle on this file. It's a top priority because it's connected to our own national security, connected to the water file, connected to the second file, which is Sudan. 2 years from now, we have witnessed that coup that undermined the stability of North Sudan against the leader of the Sudanian army, Mr. Al-Burhan, by a terroristic group, what they call it, Fast Support, Hamiti, and that terroristic personnel and militias that are supported by regional powers, regional regimes, and of course some foreign regimes. This goes right to the heart of our own national security.
Of course.
This is against our own international southern borders. Or international security, southern borders, to be exact. This is against our national security. And we should, and we are We have all remembered how Mr. President has received Mr. Al-Burhan here in Egypt, the leader of the Sudanese army.
Of course.
This is the sort of support that we always giving to the Sudanese, especially that if the Hamiti organization has controls the land that contains gold mines and uranium mines, that means that our neighbor will be a terroristic regime.
Of course. But then the timing of the visit and also the nature of the visit is very important. It reflects a lot of good signs. Now, that meeting that happened, that meeting between the Egyptian president and the Somali one, of course, is going to focus on very important highlights, and also is going to reflect certain plans and certain visions. If you like to elaborate.
This is the step that the Somalian people have waited for. This is very important and successful meeting and summit between the two leaders, and goes side by side by declaring the establishing of a new embassy, Egyptian embassy in Mogadishu, and of course signing a military agreement with Somalia. This is the top priority. This is the most important thing in this visit. And I expect that Mr. President, Mr. Fattah Sisi, I believe that he might just pay back the visit and go to Somalia to prove that Egypt is truly supporting that nation, that state, and its own national security southern borders. This is very important. We have already a whole lot of fleet in the Red Sea to protect. But also there are lots of fleets in the Red Sea. So we should recognize how the dangers are. It's a true danger. What's going on in Yemen, the Houthi organization, terroristic organization, that is belonging and masterminded by Iran against the Arabic lands, is also threatening Egypt, threatening our own Suez Canal, threatening our national security in the Red Sea. The Red Sea is an Arabic sea. Any threat in this sea, that means a threat to each and every country, Arabic country around it, and African country. That goes, that takes us to the third file, which is Libya. Libya is so much connected to our own national security, to the north and to the south.
Of course. Let's talk about signing the military cooperation protocol between Egypt and Somalia. At the time, we have neighboring conflicts worldwide, and we have also international conflicts. So if you'd like to elaborate more over signing a military cooperation with Somalia at this time.
Well, this is a very important step and positive step. And it's we have this strategy that we are really doing each and every step declared worldwide. We are dealing with honor and with dignity. And we are declaring that we are supporting our brothers in Somalia. Our brothers, they are our brothers in this continent. The same thing goes to each and every country, in Rwanda, in Niger, in Chad, in each and every country of this that represents our own national security borders. Also, that can help us take more actions on this field. If any hostile actions taken against Somalia, that will be representing and a hostile action against our own army. And that's a very important thing to hear about, that we are taking it seriously and we are using our own soft powers along with our harsh powers and tough powers.
And strategies also.
Yes, it should go side by side, shoulder to shoulder. We are standing with Somalia, which is with each and every power that we have.
What other fields of probably economic cooperation and probably security cooperation? Security is so much underlined, and also political cooperation. Let's talk about security and political cooperation between us and Somalia. I mean, generally speaking, talking about Somalia, what exactly is the, how important is Somalia politically and strategically and security-wise to Egypt?
Somalia has been under severe crises since the end of the colonization. And it was deliberately, of course, whether the terroristic groups, whether the American assault against Somalia, whether too many files. So it's a weak country. It's a weak country. And it needs help. If we don't give our help to our neighbors and our brothers, the enemy will use this this weakness of relations, and that's why we are strengthening our relations right now with Somalia. They need our own capabilities. They need our own support, security or military or politically, whatsoever. Each and every power in this world have its influence zone, and Somalia is a very in the heart of our own influence zone, and this is not we are brothers who are protecting each other.
But that's, we also have the same front lines and the same securities and
exactly.
the same threats.
We have the same best interests. We have the same goals as nations.
On that note, of course, Mr. Amr Abdulrahman, our political analyst, would like to thank you so much for coming over to the Breakfast Show.
Thank you for coming, sir.
And you have a beautiful day. And I guess we're going to go to a short break and we'll come to continue the Breakfast Show, so stay with us.